Shona, Sundia Tomo. Mary, where did I put the envelope you gave me? Put it in my bag. You saw me put it in my bag. Okay.
Okay. So we'll hear from you two, then we'll also hear from her. Okay.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming to this occasion. We're from the Reminac Comics Writing Competition. I want to thank Kenny G. Mulinde from Uganda's company in Uganda, and the Little Film Project once again, and the forward from Eliana Junior School. My name is Patua Kranima, and I'm now the creative director of Reminac Comics.
Thank you very much. My name is Nsile Kohad, a teacher of Eliana Junior School. I'm so humbled to be here, to be part of this. We are grateful to Reminac Comics for having identified our school as one of the schools to work with. We are very grateful for that. And I want to thank them for having been able to tap into the writing talent of our young children. And we are very supportive of that. As a school, it's within our curriculum policy to support the writing skill, especially creative writing. So we are very grateful to be part of this, and we shall go on working with that. Thank you very much.
It's really interesting because we are using COVID, as I heard you write, to expand the horizons of the young.
And speaking of the young, the youth,
we have somebody right next to me. What's your name?
Nyangoma Mary Franklyn.
Okay, all right, Franklyn. So, you've got...
Hey, clap for her. She's a winner, right? You won.
She's a very fast winner for that.
Yeah, please.
We want all the winners
on stage, because we're all winners here, right? Okay, so now, how do you feel about winning? What did you write about, first of all? You won the writing competition, right? So what did you write about?
I wrote about
what is our elephant, what is the one who created
the
dragon,
and the one who
created the dragon. It's okay, it's alright, don't worry. Don't cry, God doesn't want you to cry.
Happy.
Yeah, that's great. Now I can see why she feels it. I think a lot of the writers nowadays, the old writers, like our age, we don't have the feeling you have, which is a good thing. Yeah, you have a lot of passion. That's what you call passion. Okay? Are you okay? You're fine? Yeah. So when you talk about God, you should rejoice.
I'm the illustrator of the book, and when I read this story, I even said, come one by one, one by one, and we want to go to the prototype and see what the writer wanted to envision in her work, and they wanted to bring out the best way possible. So we designed the character, the way the hobo wore the costume looks like, it's symbolic. The cross, the scarf represents the blood of Jesus. The belt represents the scripture in the book of Paul, it is symbolic, and what I'm saying is that cover your waist with the belt of truth, and the cross represents, of course, the suffering of Christ as well. Like, and it's been a privilege to illustrate that book. And I'm very happy that I began this, and I got a privilege of illustrating such a great book.
I can see you're also emotional about it. Okay.
Well, everybody's, you really touched a lot of hearts.
Even now, it's a feeling. You should be happy with that, okay? Very few of us touch people's hearts. Oh, this is the comic, right here.
Yeah.
You maybe could say something.
So, the scarf represents the blood of Jesus, the cross, the suffering of Christ, the belt, the scripture, I think it's in Corinthians, where Paul says, cover yourself. So this character doesn't lie, but she stands for virtue and righteousness, and she fights evil wherever she finds it. You know, it's my inspiration. When I read that story, that's what I thought she wanted to be. And here I just say this out loud to everybody. I am so pleased that I wanted to get this kind of message out with the hope of my creative team as well. So
I want to congratulate my girl, Nyangoma Franklyn. I want to thank her parents for the upbringing. In fact, when you look at our educated schools and teachers in particular, to encourage children to write, even if it's not for publication like this, you should encourage children to write and write and write. Because through writing, they express how they feel. When you look at Nyangoma's story, it is in tandem with her character. When you look at Nyangoma, that is her. So don't even think the tears are coming from. That is Nyangoma. And I want to thank her for writing from deep her heart. Because even when she told about her story, you see realism in that. So thank you very much, Nyangoma. And as a school, we shall continue to support you and other young writers to be able to develop their writing talent. Thank you very much once again to Reminac Comics.
Yes, Reminac Comics. To a message to Franklin's classmates. I think some of us went to the museum and we were looking at a Ford car, right? Yeah, so that Ford car is many years old. The beauty with writing is that when we're all gone, maybe
in 100 years from now,
people will still have access to these books.
So it's
a form of
immortality.
You live forever when you write what you think and what you feel. So
very soon, in about
200 years, people will be talking about that. People your age.
How do you feel about that?
Yeah. So you already feel old, like you're 200. I'm joking.
Okay.
But writer's block is, have you ever felt when you're not in the mood to write?
Yes.
Oh, really? What causes that?
Okay.
So children, can you stop shouting? Alright? We have a writer who's busy. Okay? Okay? Can we make a deal? If you see, if you make the writer angry, she'll write a story about you, and in that story something bad may happen. Right? Yeah. So don't upset the writer. Okay? So that's what gives you writer's block. How often do you write? How many times? You write every day. Wow, okay.
She actually has issue to an issue to of the help of God.
She has what?
She has already written a story about issue two of the help of God and issue three. And we are going to look into it and see how this can be done. Wow. That's how she is.
And the headmaster, I think, how do you feel? I mean, you must be very proud.
Well, I feel proud, feeling proud of the many talents that I see coming up, and I would like to encourage schools to always create a classroom environment that can provoke children to think and be creative. Not only think about teaching the content in the scheme of work, but create a wider range of avenues where children can express how they feel, let them talk about what they feel like during the lessons. Through their talking, we pick up so many things from them. They are young, but I want to tell you they have amazing ideas. So thank you the teachers, thank you Teacher Annette, thank you Teacher Pape, and the rest of the team at Eliana Junior School and the pupils, thank you very much.
Tell us something more.
We are officially launching the Hope of God today, right after this panel. It's going to be officially on sale at only 10,000 shares.
Okay, so we're going to launch the Hope of God. So open your book. Don't cry, because we like it when you smile. We like it so much. So, okay. Please clap for the noise for our writer. Thank you.
My name is Nyangoma Mary, and we have loved my book, The Helper of God, to help people to understand who is God, to help people that do not believe in witchcraft, to help people that this book will understand you.